You work for Microsoft, one of the most dynamic companies in the world. But there's a lot you probably don't know about this place. So let's do some micro spotting. This is the Microsoft Model Shop. All right, we're here in the Model Shop with Vince Jesus. What exactly happens in this room?
What exactly happens here?
That you're allowed to tell me about.
We create the part from the art. So designers and engineers, they have all their data on CAD. Now what they need to do is feel it, see it, and touch it. And so in order for them to do that, we actually create the physical prototypes and models here in the shop.
And this is all so that when somebody else takes the product to the team that they're presenting it to, it looks exactly the way they want so that they can best express their vision.
Yep.
Have they ever come back to you after a pitch that didn't go well and said, Vince, you let me down?
No. No.
But you're a pretty big guy. I think they might be afraid of you. Now, you guys work on a lot of things that are very top secret.
With Surface, we actually worked in the very front end, the ideation of the product. And it was very hard because we had to keep it tight. So we had to be very careful in how we do our work. And in fact, locked off several rooms that were just secured and did the work behind those doors.
Did it work? Did it stay totally secret?
It did.
Well, can we go check out the 3D printer?
Oh, absolutely.
Tell me a little bit about the Connex 500.
So the Connex 500 is our newest addition to our 3D printing. Its specialty is printing what they call digital materials. So we can print multiple materials at the same time. So we can print an elastomer and a rigid material, so we can do things like that.
Can anybody at Microsoft call you guys up or email you and say, hey, can you make me some nunchucks? Like, can people request things and you guys will, if they have the right kind of, you guys will go ahead and print it up in here?
It actually needs a business justification in order for that to happen. We run these printers pretty much 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. We buy $150,000 worth of resin every year. This is a bicycle chain, and we actually printed it out, and it printed out as a single part. And when we were done, we had an articulated bike chain.
I have a tiny hamster bike that I actually have needed a chain for. Could I borrow this for that? Did you do wood shop when you were in high school?
I did.
Does this place ever remind you of wood shop?
It does, yep.
What kind of grades did you get?
I don't remember.
Let's say you guys get a call in the model shop. We need a new idea for a mouse, and we want to present it. So can you guys please build us said mouse? They email you the designs. It starts here, basically?
So this block, they're sketching the plan view of a product that they're thinking about. The room that we have here, not only do we cut, but we have a sander, we have a bandsaw. When it gets to this point where they're starting to think more about their idea and it's becoming more of what they want, then they start doing real fine sculpting. And if you can see here, this is all hand done. Once they get here, we put what reference points here, and then we would scan it. So now we have it in digital form. From the digital form then, we can take that and 3D print it.
I have one last question in here. What's the policy on leaving my scraps here?
If you leave your scrap here, then you won't come back.
All right, well, Vince, thanks a lot, man.
Oh, yeah, you're welcome.
Appreciate it. Thanks for taking us here to the model shop and for letting me know where not to leave my junk. What are these things made out of? Because I touched them and then I licked my hands and I'm starting to feel a little dizzy.